Hey, what's up, y'all? Welcome back to Dish Nation. Now, I have the artist with us, formerly known as the baby alien, the one, the only, Mark Sanchez. What's up, Mark?
What's up, man? Thanks for having me, bro.
Yo, thank you so much for pulling up on us. It looked like you was having an amazing time on the pad, man. How fun was that for you?
It truly was a blast. You know, this multi-layered onion, this three-headed monster that I was dealing with, but it was really, really fun.
Like, prior to being asked to do the show, were you a fan of it?
Yes, I'd seen it before. I'd seen other players on it. I was actually supposed to do season three, and it just didn't work out logistics and timing-wise. But they circled back for season four, and they said, you know, we got these, you know, different costumes this year and this season, so you might be interested in this puppet costume. And I was like, puppet costume? Okay, like, explain. And they sold it hard.
So what was running through your mind when you first get the call, you know, to sing?
I was definitely nervous. It felt a lot better than when they asked about Dancing with the Stars, because I'm not the best dancer. But it was challenging. I had to practice with this weighted backpack. I would run up and down my stairs. The vocal coach told me to do that, so I'm winded when I start practicing the song instead of just sitting down in a chair and belting out a tune. It just wouldn't simulate the atmosphere. And to be totally honest, is very similar, if not exactly the same, as the nerves you get playing football. And so for the first performance, you hear these clicks in your ear, right, with your earpiece and the instrumentals that are about to come on. There's these four clicks, and by the third click, my heart kind of sank before the first one started, and I was like, oh my God, this is for real.
You had the judges thrown with that British accent. Were you working on other accents before you decided to land on that one?
And I was messing around with the Southern accent, like, hey, y'all, and they're like, you know, that's all right. And then I did this Borat accent, and they were just like, oh my God, yes, please do that.
Well, like, you know, you did really well at a Masked Singer. Like, you know, you did great in the NFL. If you had to pick one or the other to go back to for one last hurrah, which one would you rock with?
Wow. I mean, football is my first love, but dang, that's tough. I'd like to go give another performance, bro. I can't lie. That was really fun. I told you, you get that rush, and it was incredible being on stage and performing like that.
Now, if you could tag anybody in from the NFL to be on The Masked Singer, who would you tag in?
Ooh, gosh. You know who actually can sing pretty well is Tua Tagovailoa, the quarterback.
Really?
He's got some pipes, bro. He loves karaoke, too. He'd be perfect for the show.
If you could strike the worst football play ever from your record, or the worst Masked Singer performance from your record, which one would you strike off?
I don't remember any bad plays from playing football. That's crazy.
Okay.
Nope. Can't think of any.
None? But.
But. No. Still no.
Man, continued success on all you're doing and everything you got going on. And much love to you and your family. And be sure you check out the next episode of The Masked Singer on Fox. And your favorite celebrity just might be under the mask. You never know, man. Shout out to you, Mark, one time.
Appreciate it, bro. Thank you so much for having me.
Hey, don't forget to hit us up on social media. We're on all these platforms at Dish Nation. We'll see you there.